Omnisphere's got an incredible assortment of built-in effects processor plugins. They're referred to as effects units. And we organize these effects units into racks. There's up to 58 different effects. They can be organized into 37 racks. And there's a ton of presets. Now, there are patch effects and multi-effects. I'm going to focus on patch-based effects in this video. So effects are organized into these racks, and each rack can contain up to 4 effects units. So let's look at the part-based effects. Now, each part can be accessed, as we know, by clicking on the different part number in the header. And whenever we click on that, we can click on the effects button over here, and this brings up the effects racks for each part. I'm going to go to 1, and I have a patch loaded in to part 1, so we're seeing the effects rack now that's associated with part 1. Now, patch effects can have 4 effects racks. We have one for layer A, one for layer B, a common one for both, and an aux rack. And as you can see here, there are 4 effects unit slots for layer A, 4 for the layer B, and then we have a common rack that affects both of them together, plus we have an aux rack. Now, in A and B, we have sends over here. So if we have effects loaded in here, we can send to the send rack. And we can do that for A and B. And then in this aux rack, we have a return where we set the master level. So basic send and return. And the common rack has an aux send as well. Now, in layer A and B, there's a pre and post switch, meaning that the audio sent to the aux rack can be either pre or post the actual layer level. So these are part-based effects. We have the layer A, layer B, the common effects, and the aux effects, and we can choose each part and get to the effects for each part that way. Now, when we're working in multi-mode, we have on the effects page here in multi-mode an additional 4 aux sends, aux 1, 2, 3, 4, and a master effects rack, and this affects the entire multi, all the parts together. Now, when we're in the mixer here, we can send from each of the 8 parts, we can send uniquely to each of the 4 auxes to dial in the amount we want, and then the master affects everything. So let's look at working with these effects. Now we can load an effects unit into a rack by clicking the downward pointing triangle here on any of the desired slots. Right now this one is empty, but these are empty as well. Let's go to here. And we can choose from any of the effects units in these various categories. I'm not going to go through every effects here, but this is how you select them all. So let's load one in. For example, I'll load in a modulation effect, maybe a phaser. Now, a lot of these have a dry wet slider, especially these time-based effects. And the rest of the controls are fairly intuitive if you're used to working with effects plugins. Now, we can select a different effects unit in the same slot, or we can remove an effects unit by clicking the same triangle, and we can just change to a different one, or we can go no effect like that. Now we can click the oval effects name to bypass it. So for example, I'll call one of these up again, and I'll put it on and then off. So we can bypass them easily that way. And it's also worth mentioning that almost all of the effects loaded into these part racks can be modulated, and they can be used as modulation targets. And they can also be MIDI learned as well, so you can animate these parameters over time. Now we have a ton of presets that we can work with here, and there's 2 types of presets. They're effects unit presets and effects rack presets. So for example, if I click the little triangle next to each of these effects units, I can get different presets that pertain to that unit, and I'll call up different settings. And we can also save our own effects, copy them, and paste them from here as well, and you'll be prompted to the correct location that you need to save them in. Now, the menu on top here allows us to load in complete racks. So they're nice, interesting starting points there to replace the whole rack. They don't all have 4 different effects units in them, but we can load complete racks in there and, again, save and copy and paste these effects racks as necessary. So that's a little intro and overview of working with effects in Omnisphere, and I'll see you for more in the next video.